Hi guys, welcome to Pradeep's channel. Hope everyone is doing good and staying safe. In this video, I will show you step-by-step process to start growing vegetables in your garden. So there are few things you need to know before you start planting for every year. So first thing, right, let's go to Google. Go to Google and search for planting guide. So when you search for planting guide, so scroll down, so go to this website, Gilmore website. They have clearly shown what are the different steps you need to follow. First thing is, you need to know what is your zone. So when I say zone, so it is a gardening zone. So depending on the location, so it is like USDA has been given a different zone, so that like depending on the zone and the location, so there are different plants or vegetables you can grow. So let's find out which zone you are. So let's scroll down. So I am in 28027. You have to enter your zip code. Click on continue. So it will show you. So if you see here, right, so I am in planting zone 7. So what does that mean, right? So let's go back. So go and search. Yeah, let's go. Let's type planting guide and scroll down. Yeah, go to this website, which is ufseeds.com, and here, so when I say zone, right, so depending on the state you are, so the zones are separated. If you see, I am in North Carolina, and which comes under zone 7, okay. And so the next thing, right, so now you are good that you know what is your zone. The second thing you need to know is, in your zone, what are the different vegetables or plants you can grow. So you can't just grow whatever plants you want, because it all depends on the climate and weather. So I'm in zone 7. So click on this zone. If you see here, right, down, this is all links. Click on the zone 7. So I'm in zone 7. If you scroll down, they have clearly mentioned which plant, when you can start growing, and till when you can harvest. So let's go down, and there is a better picture where they have clearly shown what is the planting schedule, right? So this is what you need to follow. So you can't just like take example, right, cucumber. So cucumber, it is advisable you have to plant in May, right? The once the weather is good, depending on the zone, this has been identified or decided by the USDA. So now, like for me, right, for now, so now we are almost nearing March. So first I want to know, so what are the plants or what are the vegetables I can grow? So first one is, I am interested in tomatoes, spinach, and pepper. So this is what I am planning to seed. Yeah, this is what you need to know before you start seeding or planting your vegetables. Okay, so let's start seeding now. So first thing is, you have to prepare your pots. So these are my old pots which I am using, and you have to start putting soil. So you can use a potting soil or garden soil. Yeah, better pot the plants where you get sunlight. So I'm mowing my pots in my garage, so where I get sunlight. So now I am done with putting the soil, and I have moved the pots near sunlight. So let's check on next steps. So these are the few seeds which I have saved from last year. So normally I don't bring plants from store. So for this year, right, once the season is done, so normally I save all the seeds from all the plants, and I keep it aside, and for the next year I use the same plants. And if you see this, right, these are the seeds from tomatoes, so which I am separating now, and I'll be seeding now. So before you sow seeds, it's very important you need to make sure So soil is good and has all the nutrition for the seeds or plants. So I normally recommend, so mix soil with this organic food, which I normally use for all my vegetables. I have put a link in description. You can buy from there. Yeah, don't over put, just you have to just sprinkle little bit and just you have to mix with the soil. So now our soil is ready to sow the seeds. So normally I save all my seeds in this medication box. Maybe you can use the same. So I normally separate all the seeds in different boxes so that it will be easy to identify. So now, like, if you see, I'm sowing tomatoes. So make sure you are sowing the seeds a bit further and giving space for each seed to grow. And when it starts getting roots, right, so it can get better air and nutrition from the soil. So now, so as we are in February in zone 7, so now I am planning to sow tomatoes, so pepper, eggplant and chilies. So once you sow the seeds, sprinkle some soil on the seeds, but don't push too much soil. It is just to cover the seeds. So now we are done with sowing the seeds, and the next step is to name the pot with the plant name. So I normally use this pop sticks where I write the plant name and put in the pot. So once you are done naming the pot, so the next step is to pour water. So don't put too much water. You have to just make the top soil wet and just like seeds get some water. So finally we are done with sowing the seed, and we started our gardening in 2021. And just one thing is, I've placed aluminium foils underneath the pot so that my floor is not getting wet when I pour the water. And one more important point is, so depending on the weather, so water your soil maybe alternate days, or when you see the top soil is dry. And next step is, once the weather is getting better, maybe mid of April or first week of May, you can move all these plants to ground. This was my garden in 2020. What? Hope this video is helpful. And if you like this video, please like, comment, and subscribe to my YouTube channel. So happy gardening.